Hello everyone! Hope you're all good and well out there in the world. If the last year of worldwide crisis hasn't been enough to bring your mood down, then oh boy, do I have a movie for you. I am Torstein from Cinema Terror, and this is Japanese extreme cinema at its most disturbing, as today I will be talking about the 1995 shocker All Night Long Part 2. All Night Long 2 is of course a sequel to the first All Night Long from 1992, which I do have an old video review of up somewhere on my channel. This one tells a new tragic, dark story and is unrelated to the first one in terms of plot and characters. It does however keep the same themes, and it goes even further into the nasty madness. Our main character is Alone Shinichi. He gets blackmailed for money by a sadistic gang of thugs who find enjoyment in torture and sexual abuse. The leader of this gang is a young man who makes Patrick Bateman look like a nun, and he is beyond sadism. He becomes romantically interested in Shinichi, and starts to manipulate and seduce him, both to get close to him and gain his trust, but also to eventually abuse him in every way possible. While he is under a constant threat to torment, Shinichi makes a few new friends over the internet and invites them back to his place for a fun evening. Unfortunately for them, the evil gang has decided to make a home visit to Shinichi that very same night. What follows is an exercise in torture, degradation, and misery that will last all night long. All Night Long 2 is not a lot of fun, and it never tries to be. This is a hopeless, unsettling shocker of a movie that only exists for the purpose of making you angry and disgusted. This one does not waste any time before showing the filth on screen, exchanging the more story-driven build-up from the first one with shocking atrocities making up for most of the entire running time of 68 minutes. It's easy to dismiss sick movies like this as torture porn for the perverted, but I don't feel that's entirely fair. There are countless low-budget horror movies that only focus on the sadistic part of human nature, but only a few of them are able to get under anyone's skin. Most of the movies that try to be as shocking and disturbing as possible will be amateurish crap that no one will care about, so when you see a film that actually gets you uncomfortable and changes your entire mood, then I believe there is something of value and quality behind it. Are there also some social commentary and themes in All Night Long 2 that are worth investigating? Yeah. For those who like to dwell deeper into the true meaning of movies, then you can absolutely do that with this one, but I'm not sure if you want All Night Long 2 stuck in your brain for long after finishing it.
Young! San!
Even though I've seen my fair share of disturbing movies, All Night Long 2 still managed to get to me. It was the type of movie experience where you want it to be over, not because it is bad and you're not engaged, but rather because you want to escape from the misery. It speaks to the effectiveness that director Katsuya Matsumara was able to get out of this small production. Matsumara must be the most depressive filmmaker ever. He cannot have a positive view on human beings, considering that he not only made this one, but also the 5 other entries to the All Night Long series. He also did the equally insanely shocking Concrete Encased High School Girl Murder Case. Yeah, that's a real film title. And he also did a movie I have not seen called Dark Love, Rape. Quite the filmography. I think the actors in All Night Long 2 deserves a lot of praise for being able to handle all of the terrible stuff they are put through. And there are some strong performances here. The show stealer is the actor who plays the gang leader, and I'm sorry that I couldn't figure out what his name is. He looks like he could fit right in with a J-pop group, but his heart is darker than the devil himself. He is a fascinating character, and the fact that there are people out there in the world with that little empathy in them makes it even more scary. I'll take dreams about Freddy Krueger any day instead of sharing breathing space with this bastard. The leading guy, Shinichi, is set up to be the one that we as viewers are supposed to care about, but that's quickly thrown out the window as he turns out to be a vile piece of shit as well. There are some not so subtle hints of his sexual preference or disturbing past, and it is not good. Not good at all. The only small hint of humanity comes from his friends, but they are not given that much time, as we can of course not have any nice people taking up any screen time. All Night Long 2 is a movie that tells you human beings are the most evil living creatures on Earth. It's a sadistic trip to the darkest side of us, and it is hard to see through. This is not a film for anyone who wants to be entertained. This is for the few who wants to be uncomfortable and see how much a movie can affect you. I look at movies as an emotional art form, and whenever a film can make me laugh, cry, shiver in fright, or get any other emotion out of me, then I have to say that it is a well-made film. I haven't watched anything that has made me feel so miserable in quite some time, so I feel like I have to give All Night Long 2 the surprisingly great score of 4 out of 5. Have you seen All Night 2 or any of the other ones in the series? What are your thoughts on them? And what's the last time you felt shock, anger, or misery while watching a movie? And I mean a movie that makes you intentionally feel that way, not a movie that you get angry at for being bad. Drop your thoughts in the comment section below. And make sure to subscribe, punch the like button, eject the bell thingy, or whatever else that is going on with YouTube these days, and I'll see you again for more videos on all kinds of weird horror stuff here on Cinema Terror. Thank you!